الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. أحبتي وأحبائي في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. As usual, الحمد لله رب العالمين. This is the month of Ramadan and this is the month of the Quran. So once in a while, we shed some lights and some understanding and we draw some conclusion and enhance our knowledge about some ayat of the Quran. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We are in Surah Al-Furqan, chapter 25. And in this chapter, Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen, you will find one thing when you think about it deeply, try to understand what is going on in this surah. Subhanallah, it is so amazing. It is so wonderful. It is so beautiful to understand those things. In this surah, starting from ayah 60 till the end of the chapter 77, about 17 ayah of the Quran, in Surah Al-Furqan, talking about one concept, amazingly enough, Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. What is that concept? Ar-Rahman, one of the attributes of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. As we all know, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has 99 attributes, and this is one of them. And we always read it, at the beginning of any chapter, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And for Ar-Rahman, some of us would look just at the translation, most gracious, Ar-Rahman, that's it. We do not think deeply about that wonderful meaning of that Ar-Rahman. And when you read it in Surah Al-Fatiha, when you read there, chapter number one, in your Salah, once you have that great, deep, wonderful meaning, it would move you. It would make you say, Ya Allah, this is one of the attributes of the 99 attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I know the meaning of it. I'm not just saying it because I'm saying it. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. What it means? Subhanallah, in this chapter, chapter al-Furqan, Allah put it in the most amazing part, subhanallah. When you think about it, Ya Allah, what is going on? Allah is giving us about the attributes, the characters of those Ibadur Rahman, the servants of the most gracious. Who are they? What they do? How they behave? How they communicate? How we relate to each other? And so on and so forth. So amazing. 11. There in those 17 ayat. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started in a wonderful way to draw our attention to some people when it goes like this. الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَبَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heavens and earth and anything in between in how many days? 60 days. Not in our estimate. 60 days. In His own estimate of the 60 days. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. The throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is totally and absolutely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sitting there. No authority, no power, no nothing, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stawa ala al-arsh. Are you following me? Look at what's going on. Ar-Rahman. Ya Allah. Who created those whole universe, heaven and earth and anything in between and have the throne and be settled with, it is the most gracious, Ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahman. Now look at what's going on, what's coming. فَاسْأَلْ بِهِ خَبِيرًا. We did not understand what Ar-Rahman means. Go ask an expert in the interpretation of the Quran to tell you what Ar-Rahman means. Because sometimes as Muslims we're taking everything for granted. Say Ar-Rahman, 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 Bismillah Ar-Rahman, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We know them, no, we do not know the meaning. فَاسْأَلْ بِهِ خَبِيرًا. Go and ask in order to learn. This is your deen, this is your Islam. You read it and recite it every day. You know, in Surah Al-Fatiha, how many times? Almost 37 times a day in your Salah, Fard. Not the non-obligatory one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us one of the greatest challenges ever. So some people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ, when it is said to those specific people, that category of people, really unfortunate among us Muslims, اسْجُدُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ, prostrate, go deep down, have that sujood lirrahman. Make sure that you have those seven parts of your body in your sujood. Your forehead, the best of you. Palms and fingers. Your knees and your toes. If you count them, there are seven. Seven parts of your body. Touching the ground, totally. If any one of them miss touching the ground, not the carpet. This is a nice carpet. Imported from Egypt, by the way. But go try it in your backyard to touch the dirt where we came from and when we're going to go to. Okay? When they are told, isjudu lirrahman, make this judu to the most gracious, said what? Qalu, wa man rahman? Who is that most gracious? What you're talking about? You, subhanAllah. Some people are rejecting. Some people do not make that sujood. They don't care. And also they ask, subhanAllah, وَمَا الرَّحْمَانِ أَنَسْجُدُ لِمَا تَأْمُرُنَا. يعني you're giving us a command and order, you Muhammad, to have that sujood, to obey your order and commands. وَزَادَهُمْ نُفُورًا. Once they said what they said, they are totally rejected from Islam. The following ayat, we do not have enough time, but inshallah, I promise you, tomorrow, we'll be talking about those 11 attributes of Ibadur Rahman. The rest of the surah. The rest of the surah, subhanAllah. 11 attributes, subhanAllah. Who are they, Ibadur Rahman? We'll talk about it, inshallah. But let me shed some lights in here about the sujood and the significance of it. And why you're making the sujood. Why? Ruku', tayyib. Qiyam, Allahu Akbar, Fatiha. Yani short surah of the Quran, ruku', tabwa, sujood. Aqarabu ma yakunu al-abdu ila rabbihi wa huwa sajid. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The closest point you are in the servant of Allah, the closest point you are in you, the servants of Allah, while you have sujood with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The closest one. The lowest in a position you are, the highest in connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heaven. Can you imagine? Yeah, not even in ruku', wallahi. Not even while you're standing. No, in sujood. Because I am having the best of me touching the ground. I am humbling myself. I know we're created from dirt and dust, and we're gonna go back to dirt and dust after we live our life. When I am done with my prayer, I look at my brother to my right, my brother to my left, behind me, front of me, sisters, you are much better than me, wallahi. I am not more than you in anything. You are in the sight of Allah much better than me, because I got the best of me in the ground there. So when I'm dealing with you, after I dealt with Allah, I love you, I respect you, I care about you, I can do anything for you, because you are my brother and my sister in Islam. That's why the ibadah would move you to the relationship. Ibadah is not just for the ibadah. Ibadah is just to help us to translate our iman to action, to put our iman in action. Once I'm done with that special meeting with Allah in my sujood, and then I will come to you are the best ever. You are the best ever in my sujood. Keep in mind that sujood. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. And also, you want your dua to be accepted in your sujood. In your sujood. One of the best situation ever, when you make the dua, when you are humiliating yourself to Allah, when you're in that lowest point ever, when you're having your forehead and you're touching the ground and you cry in tears, ask Allah. Anything would accept. It would come in a day, it would come in a week, it would come in a month, it would come any time, but it would be accepted. So keep in mind that sujood, and keep in mind that sujood you do it for whom? Ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahman. I promise you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, to continue this topic, inshallah, to look at those 11 characters of Ar-Rahman in Surah Al-Furqan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. اللهم اجعل في قلبي نورا وفي لساني نورا واجعل في سمعي نورا واجعل في بصري نورا واجعل في خلقي نورا ومن أمامي نورا واجعل من فوقي نورا ومن خلفي نورا ومن تحتي نورا اللهم أعطني نورا اللهم نور قلوبنا وعقولنا وقبورنا وأجسامنا يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.